Hi folks, John Zajeros here with UltimateBadBackStrategies.com, and today I want to talk about choosing a gym. Now, choosing a gym is probably the second most important decision you're going to make when it comes to your neck pain, back pain, and sciatica relief strategy. Second only to choosing your medical practitioner. I would say that it's even more important than choosing your physical therapist. Because in actuality, you don't pick your physical therapist usually. You're referred to somebody, you go to them until your insurance runs out, and then you're on your own. You know, there aren't too many physical therapists that'll keep seeing you once the insurance runs out. And that usually happens pretty quick nowadays. So what do? Well, you know, we've been through the stage where we stretch and then we start walking, we add a few exercises, but now it's time to look at a gym. And the weather's changing here in the Midwest in the United States, but regardless of where you are in the world, there comes a time where you really have to start thinking about a long-term neck pain, back pain, and sciatica relief exercise program. And the best place to do that is in a good gym. Now, I say a good gym. It's very important as you pick your gym that you match your personality with the gym's personality. Because just like you have your own distinct personality, the gym will have one as well. And from the music they play, to the sort of equipment they have, to the clientele, you're going to find that the gym is going to either be a good match, a fair match, or it's going to be one of those places that you just kind of turn around and walk back out of. And believe me, there are a lot of those. So be careful as you choose your gym. Now, there are several things that you want to look at. One, you want to look at the music they play. You know, it might sound silly, but it gets old if you have to wear headphones all the time because you can't stand the music they play. And everybody's tastes are different. You want to check the locker room. Make sure that it's clean. Make sure that the lockers are well kept. Find out if you can leave a lock on overnight. If there's an additional charge, it's worth paying for. Just to make sure that you have supplies that, like soap and things like that, so you don't have to haul them back and forth. As long as the charge isn't too much. A lot of the nicer places will actually assign a locker, but you know, that gets a little pricey. So when you're looking at the gym, you want to look at the music, you want to look at the cleanliness, but most importantly, you want to look at the staff. And how you do this is by insisting that your first couple of visits, your trial visits, before you sign or agree to anything, are with a member of the staff. And make it very clear that you have neck pain, back pain, and sciatica issues. See who they match you up with first. And if the match is a bad one, ask for somebody who's competent. Ask for somebody who is familiar with working with people with neck pain, back pain, and sciatica issues. Preferably someone who has had neck pain, back pain, and sciatica issues. Because they'll bring empathy to the table, and that changes the dynamics completely. That really helps to build a lasting relationship with your trainer. Now, we'll get into choosing a good personal trainer and why you should take that extra step in many cases. But in this video, we're concerned most of all with just the gym itself. So we've talked about the music, we've talked about cleanliness. The staff is key. Make sure that they're attentive. Make sure that they're fully in tune with you while they're working with you and that they accommodate your particular needs because you have very particular issues and you want to make sure, regardless of the alphabet soup, you know, I've met people with all kinds of credentials that weren't worth their salt, and I've met people who have trained people for years, and I've trained athletes for 30 years, and I don't have a certification, but I have to tell you something. I trained some of the best people in the world, and I've had enough surgeries and enough issues with my back, and I've brought myself back enough times to know how to train somebody properly, that I do a good job with people. You want to find someone who is going to take a personal interest in you, not just, not just a paycheck, not just a simple minimum wage staffer. You want to make sure that you get someone who is competent and qualified. And if you can't find someone who's competent and qualified, you're going to have to do one of two things. If you found the right fit with the gym and you really fall in love with it, then you're going to have to hire a personal trainer. If you're still up in the air on the gym, you might want to look around because you might get lucky and find someone on staff at one of the other facilities who's willing to take you on for little or maybe a little bit more money or perhaps none at all. Maybe it'll be included with the membership. So explore those options because they're good ones. The other thing that you want to do is you want to make sure that you visit the gym during the times that you plan on working out. This is very important. You don't want to have to stand in line for machines or weights or recumbent bikes or stationary bikes or elliptical machines or whatever else is that you want to do. You want to make sure that you have easy access to the equipment when you want to use it. And you want to make sure that you have access to the staff as well. If the machines, if the equipment, or if the staff are overburdened, overwhelmed, then find another gym. This is very important. You know, there are a lot of gyms out there. You don't have to, you don't feel obligated to join the first one because you get a high-pressure sales pitch or because you feel that, you've got some sort of reciprocal thing going with the person who's been showing you through. Make sure that you pick the right gym because this is a long-term commitment. You want to make sure that you have a lasting neck pain, back pain, and sciatica exercise program, and that means a lasting relationship with your gym. So, as I said, this is the second most important decision you make next to the medical practitioner. The only other decision that is equally important is the decision to employ a personal trainer and the choosing of that trainer. And we will get into that in the next video. But for now, that covers everything. Make sure that you have a trial period. Make sure you don't get locked into a long-term contract. Check the facility out completely. Make sure you get trial workouts with the staff. Get a complete tour of the facility and make sure that the facility matches your personality. Take care, folks. Best of luck to you and best of luck with your neck pain, back pain, and sciatica relief exercise program. Take care. Bye-bye.